guys, my name is Brittany and welcome back to my YouTube channel. You guys, in today's video, this is going to be part two of my curricula haul where I'm going to be sharing with you guys all of the books that I got for my upcoming homeschool year. Now, you guys, I try my best to use my library as best as I can when it comes to like all of like the different type of literature books that I use in our homeschool. However, these books that I purchased for our homeschool are books that I know I'm going to come back to time and time again. I shopped at Thriftbooks first, then Book Outlet, and then my last stop was, if I couldn't find the books from Thriftbooks or Book Outlet, I used Amazon. So I'm really excited, you guys, to share with you all of the books that we're going to be using for our 2024-2025 homeschooling year. So the first box I'm going to be opening up is the box from Book Outlet. I got some books for my younger ones and for my oldest daughter. So for my younger ones, I went ahead and I got the next or the last two books in the Jada Jones series. Now, I know my rising first grader is not quite at this reading level just yet, but my oldest daughter really enjoyed this series when we first started off our homeschooling journey. So I wanted to go ahead and get the last two books of the series so I can have the whole collection ready to go when, you know, my middle daughter gets to this reading level. So I'm so excited to finish off the Jada Jones series in my homeschool. The next book that I got for my littles is Mary Had a Little Plan. This is like a spinoff of Mary Had a Little Lamb, and this is the second book in the series. So I'm really excited about this one. Hopefully you enjoy this one. And I picked this up because it looks like a good like springtime book, especially, you know, since springtime is almost here. The next book that I got is a fun reader for my middle daughter, or for my oldest daughter, which is Two Naomis. I seen this, I had to grab this one for her. So hopefully she enjoys this one, added to like her collection. Now, as far as the last books that I got, I went ahead and I got all of the Mildred Taylor book series because me and my oldest daughter, we are going to read all of the series from Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry. I was inspired by Morgan from Life of the Tillmans to read these books for our read alouds this homeschooling year for my oldest, especially since this is going to be the historical time period we're going to be in. So I already have Roll of Thunder, Hear My Cry on my shelf. I've been trying to read that book, you guys, for so many years, but I'm so happy I waited until like we're actually in the time period. So hopefully my oldest will really, really enjoy it. So here is the first book, is by Mildred Taylor, which is The Land. I have The Golden Cadillac. I have The Road to Memphis. Let the Circle Be Unbroken. The Well. And this is All the Days Past and All the Days to Come. So I believe it's either 8 or 10 books in the series altogether. We're definitely going to read them all. I need to figure out like the order to read them so I make sure like we don't hit any like spoilers or anything like that. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 6 books that I ordered from Book Outlet, and then including the Roll of Thunder, I already have, it's 7 books altogether right now that I have for the Mildred Taylor series. Now, you guys, let's go ahead and open up the Amazon books that I have, that I got. Whew. And I think these are more of like my spines and resources that I'm going to be using. So I got my oldest daughter another fun reader in this book. I totally forgot about this one, but I got her Mango in the City. She read the first one, Mango Delight, last homeschooling year. As far as like a fun reader, she really enjoyed this, and I went ahead and got her the second book. So she has 2 fun readers right here ready to go for her. As far as a reference book, I got this reference book right here for my middle daughter who will be in the first grade. We're going to be doing like world cultures, world geography. So I went ahead and picked up this book, this Smithsonian book, which is Peoples and Places. So I'm really excited to use this resource in our homeschool this upcoming year. So this is what I got from Amazon. And the last thing that I got from Amazon, since we're going to be doing like world cultures, world studies, is this big book of maps. This book is huge, you guys. It is huge. It looks so awesome. So I'm so excited about this book, and hopefully all of my kids really enjoy this resource because I definitely think this is a timeless one. So this is a book of maps. apps. So yeah. So the last books that I got are books from Thriftbooks, and Thriftbooks is one of my favorite places to shop. If you guys want to shop at Thriftbooks, I definitely will say make sure you register yourself as a homeschooling family, because you're able to get like additional savings through Thriftbooks when you register on their like online reward center. So I definitely am registered like as a homeschooler, so I do get additional discounts when I use Thriftbooks, which is amazing. So the first book that I got is The Black Mother Goose. And I'm excited about this one. It looks so cool on the inside. Some of the pictures are black and white, and then some of them are colored. So this is like a nursery rhyme book that I got for my youngest. I got this book right here called Emmanuel's Dream. And then I got the rest of the Mildred Teller books that I was going to need from Thriftbooks. So this is Mississippi Bridge, Song of the Trees, and The Friendship. And I believe this ends off my whole series as far as the Mildred Teller series. Another book that I got for my oldest is Sugar. For my younger two, I got The Princess and the Pea. For my oldest, I got Massa Musa. For my younger two, I got A Story. And this is Wangar Maathai. Then I got some like folktale fairy tale books. This right here is called Her Stories. And then I got this book right here. Both of these books are actually recommendations from the Heritage Mom blog, Her Stories, and this book right here, which is The People Could Fly. These are American Black folktales. So I'm really excited that I'm adding in more like folktale books into our homeschool, especially like for like our morning time lineup. I'm able to like pull out, read one of these books, and hopefully all of my kiddos will enjoy these. So you guys, this is all of my books and my resources that I have for my 2024-2025 homeschooling year. All of the other books and things that I need, I'm going to, again, utilize my library this homeschool year. I know sometimes it can be like a pain in the butt for me because I have to wait sometimes for some of the books that I want to come in, because I do like the inner library loan where the books are getting transferred from other libraries in like my city. So sometimes I do have to be more patient in using the library, but it really has saved me and my homeschool so much money this homeschooling year by really utilizing my library effectively this year. So these are the only books I'm gonna buy, and I'm gonna again use my library for this upcoming homeschool year. So you guys, I really hope you enjoy watching and seeing all the book selections that I have, and I'm, you know, storing up for my next upcoming homeschool year. As always, you guys, thank you so much for watching today's video, and I look forward to seeing everybody in my next one. Bye.